Hey everyone, my name is Will Valida. I'm a software engineer and cloud architect. And in this video, we're going to learn how we can use GitHub Copilot in Visual Studio. So in previous videos, I focused mainly on Visual Studio Code, and we've also taken a look at how GitHub Copilot works in Azure Data Studio. But now we're going to turn our attentions and look at how GitHub Copilot works in Visual Studio, along with some very specific things that you can do with Copilot in Visual Studio. But let's start with the easy stuff. So here I've got a very basic class library and also a test project. We're going to generate some tests for my class library, which represents a calculator class, and it's a little bit bare at the moment. We've only got three methods. So the first thing I'm going to do is use an inline comment to generate some new method for us for divide. So I'm going to start a new comment, so generate a method that returns the result of dividing two numbers together. And just give Copilot a minute to think about it. And there we go. So it's got a suggestion already for what method I could use to implement. And to cycle through these, if I had multiple suggestions, we press Alt and then full stop or period if you're American. But it's only got the one suggestion. So to accept that, I could just press Tab. And there we go. There's my divide method for me. Another feature that we can use in Visual Studio is Copilot Chat. This is where we ask GitHub Copilot coding related questions in natural language. Now, there are two places that we can ask questions, the chat window or directly inline our code using inline chat. So let's take a look at the chat window first. So I'm going to open up View and then go into GitHub Copilot Chat. I can also use control backslash C. So I'm going to give that a go. And there we go. I've got GitHub Copilot chat, the chat window open here for me. So I've got an add method, a subtract method, multiply and divide. So now what I'm going to do is generate a method for the modulus operation. I'm not sure if I spelled that right, but there we go. I'm just asking it a question. I'm not giving it any file references. I'm not using any chat selections, variables, chat participants, anything like that. I'm just getting it to return a method. So it's giving me, let me get some more real estate going here. It's giving me the full class, but it's also generated a modulus method for me. So what I'm going to do is, or what I can do, is I can copy and paste the entire code block. I can insert this entire code block into a new file, or I can just preview the changes. So if I go ahead and preview or click preview, I'll get some more real estate here as well. I'll actually see the difference between the old file and the new file. And if I want to accept that, I can click accept. Or if I want to disregard that, I'll just press cancel. But I'll go ahead and accept that. I've lost my comment for my divide method, but that doesn't matter for this moment because we'll remedy that later. Cool, so I've got a modulus method there for me. Another way I can ask questions in Visual Studio to GitHub Copilot chat is using inline view. So what I can do is scroll down, just get a bit more real estate, and I should be able to ask Copilot there, but there's a hotkey for it, so I'm gonna go Alt and forward slash, and there we go. There's an inline chat open for me. And what I can do in this text box is I can ask my coding related questions. So let's go ahead and generate a new method that determines if a number is a prime number. And there we go. I go ahead and press enter or click arrow, whatever. And it's going to go ahead and generate that new method for me. So look at that. So it's given me a bit of a file diff. So there's my existing code, and there it's generated the new method for me. But that's going to go ahead and delete everything else. So I'm just going to go ahead and click cancel. And let's try that again. I'm just going to go just generate a is prime method for me. And let's see what it returns with. That's not the greatest prompt in the world, but let's have a look and see if Copilot can figure that out. So there we go. There's my prompt. And there we go. So it's just generated the is prime method for me. So again, passing in a number, and then it's going to determine whether that number is a prime number or not. And to accept that, I can just go ahead and click accept. Awesome. So my calculator library is starting to be fleshed out a little bit, which is pretty cool. But we've only really used Copilot Chat in a very basic sense. So we've only just asked it questions. There are ways that we can actually refine the prompts that we give to GitHub Copilot in Visual Studio. And one method that we can use to do that is by using slash commands. Now, slash commands in Copilot Chat help us set the intent quickly for common development tasks. So by specifying slash commands to form our questions, we can actually get better questions without having to write out long questions. So let's take a look at a couple of them in Visual Studio. So I'm going to get a bit more real estate here. And I'm going to add some comments for this add method here. So I'll just unselect that. And I'll press forward slash, and I can see the slash commands that are available to me. So documentation, explain, fix, help, optimize, and tests. We'll cover optimize in a bit. But what I'll do is I'll click doc, and I'll say the add method in. Now, another thing that we can use is set a reference using a chat variable. So what I'm going to do is just press hashtag. And there we go. So I can use different sources in Visual Studio as a reference for Copilot to use. So I can reference the file itself, I can reference the entire solution, or any file that's currently active within my project. So I'm going to go ahead and press enter because I want to document the add method in the calculator C# class. So I'm going to go ahead and press enter. And there we go. So it's given me some inline documentation that I can add to my add method. So I'm going to go ahead and just copy and paste that over my existing add method. And there we go. So rather than having to write all that myself, I've used Copilot Chat in Visual Studio to actually do that task for me. One slash command that is unique to Visual Studio is the optimize slash command. And this helps us analyze and improve the running time of the selected code. So looking at this isPrime method here, what I'm going to do, just forward slash optimize. The isPrime method in, and I'm going to select my calculator class. And let's see if Copilot can think of ways that I can actually optimize that method. Okay, so it's generated some, let's get some more real estate here and see what's going on. So it's actually generated a different implementation of this method for me. And let's have a look at the explanation. So it does some initial checks. So the method now directly returns true for numbers less than or equal to 3. It also checks for divisibility by 2 and 3, which eliminates a significant number of non-prime numbers quickly. And then it does a loop optimization. So it increments by 6 and checks for both I and I plus 2 for divisibility. And then it gives me some trade-offs as well. So it says that this method is slightly more complex, but significantly faster for larger numbers. And the readability is slightly reduced due to more complex loop conditions, but the performance gain is substantial. So I can go ahead and it's added some comments for me, which is pretty cool because it's looked at my file and said, okay, there are some comments in there. So any future suggestions, I should follow that pattern. And I'm going to go ahead and just implement that in there. And if we wanted to, we could add some benchmarks or do some performance testing to make sure that the new implementation of our isPrime method is, performs better than our previous implementation. Cool. So if I go into my solution explorer, I've got some calculator.tests. I've got a test project here. And this is using XUnit. So what I'm going to do, just open up that is calculator method again, go back into GitHub Copilot Chat. I'm going to create a new chat. And I'm going to use another slash command here, tests. And I'm going to just type, I'm just going to use test calculator.cs. So again, basically telling GitHub Copilot to write tests for me for this calculator class. And there we go. So in Visual Studio Code, sometimes I would get tests when I ask GitHub Copilot to generate tests for me in .NET. I usually get NUnit, But this time it's actually taken a look at my calculator file. It's also taken a look at the calculator test CS proj file, and it's generated some tests for me. So there we go. It's got some tests for the add method, subtract, multiply, divide. So it's given me a good starting point, but there's obviously more comprehensive tests that we can do. It's also given me some data-driven tests or inline data tests, which is pretty cool. So if I go and insert that into a new file, I can, oh, that's only gonna give it to me in that location. So actually putting that would be a little bit of a mission. So let me go ahead. I'm not gonna save that. I'm going to copy and paste that. Gonna create a new class and just call it calculator tests. There we go. Go back into Copilot chat. And there we go. So there are my tests ready and waiting for me. I'll just do a quick build. And what I want to do is actually run these tests to make sure that they're not garbage. So the build's successful. Let's run some tests. Go to Test Explorer. And some tests have failed. One test has failed. But there we go. That's given us a good starting point. So this is the thing, you know, don't always trust all the tests or all code that's generated from GitHub Copilot. We're going to say that bind zero should throw exception. But we look at that. And, well, our divide method doesn't actually do that. So we can actually go refactor the divide method in calculator class to throw an exception when a number is zero. Bit of a long prompt, but let's have a look. It's going to think about my prompt and hopefully generate a suggestion on how I can actually handle that exception. And there we go. It's generated the whole class for me. So I probably should have said, just generate that method for me. But again, get some more real estate because I've got a small screen. And there we go. So if if B is zero, it's going to throw the divide by zero exception. And I could say, just give me the method and factor in both numbers being zero. So hopefully that will just generate the method, but GitHub Copilot has this concept of a chat history. That really wasn't what I wanted, but what it's done here is how should the divide method handle the case when both numbers are zero? So I'm gonna go ahead and click that. And there we go. So it's gonna give me this method here. So what I can do is just copy and paste that for time. So now it's taking into account both numbers. If both numbers are zero, then an exception will be thrown. So hopefully when I run the test this time, all my tests should pass. Fantastic. So you see, it's an iterative process with GitHub Copilot. Don't just accept everything at face value. You know, it's going to be an iterative process, and that it's actually a little bit more effective once if you ask it multiple questions and iterate on your development process. One thing that I will test though is if I look at the solution, I can actually use that solution reference or chat variable there to ask GitHub Copilot questions about what's in my entire solution. So I can say, is there a method for determining factorial numbers or calculating the factorial of a number? So it's going to use my solution as a reference, and it's going to see if there's a method to calculate the factorial of the number. And there we go. It said, no, the provided code does not include a method. So that solution chat variable is pretty powerful for allowing you to ask questions about your entire solution. And that's unique to Visual Studio, so that's pretty cool. And it's also given me an implementation on how I can actually determine that. So what I can do, if I wanted to accept that, I can go ahead and paste that into my calculator file, but I won't do it for now. Now what I want to do is look at how we can actually debug our application using GitHub Copilot. So Copilot can actually provide code fixes along with in-depth analysis and explanations of how our code actually works. And it can help propose fixes to any bugs we might encounter and explain things such as exceptions that occur in our application. It understands call stacks, frames, variable names, values, etc. And as a result, we can actually interact with our debugger in Visual Studio to ask detailed questions related to our code and any debugging issues that we have in general. So what I've done is I've created a quick console application that implements my calculator class, and I'm actually going to go ahead and start debugging. I've added a breakpoint here into this calculator.divide method or implementation, and when I'm calling it, sorry. So let me go ahead and start debugging. Cool, so from here, what I can do is I can right-click the code and go ask Copilot, and I'm gonna say, what happens if one of the values is zero? So I'm gonna go ahead, ask that question, and hopefully inline, there we go. So in the provided code, there is division operation where the variable C is divided by A. If the value of C is zero, it will result in a runtime error called divide by zero exception. So it's gonna tell me that if I pass zero there, I'm gonna get this exception. And that's what I'm actually doing. So I'm gonna go ahead, exit out of that. And now what I'm gonna do is actually step into that. So I'm gonna actually let that exception occur. So I'm gonna press continue. And there we go. Let me get some more real estate here. Sorry, it's a very scrunched up screen because I'm trying to optimize it for good production values in YouTube. So there we go. There's my divide by zero exception. It's been occurred. So if I don't know what's going on there, I can actually ask Copilot. It's a very simple exception that's being thrown. But if you've never encountered it before, you might want to ask Copilot what's actually happening. And there we go. So I'm I clicked Ask Copilot there, and it sent a prompt saying, analyze the system divide by zero exception. And it's given me an explanation of what the exception is and what is actually happening. And it's also giving me a suggestion on how I can actually fix that. So adding a possible fix. So what I can do is I can actually handle that exception a little bit more gracefully. So I can catch that and then write that out to the console. All I'm doing at the moment is just writing this few basic lines in C# for my program .cs file. I'm not actually handling that exception. So it's given me a suggestion on how I can handle this exception a little bit more gracefully. So that's pretty cool. We can actually use GitHub Copilot to help us debug our applications in Visual Studio, which makes the debugging process a lot more straightforward. We now have an AI assistant helping us with our debugging efforts. So if we go ahead, I'm just going to go ahead, stop that. And I'm actually going to, let me open up GitHub Copilot again. I'm actually going to just copy that try catch, copy and paste that into there. And if I run that application again, there we go. So now my exception has been gracefully handled, and it's printed out to the console that division by zero is not allowed. So if this was a real world application, that exception that we've encountered during our development efforts, we've actually managed to handle that a little bit more gracefully. So when our users are using this application, they'll get a nice message saying that division by zero is not allowed, rather than getting a runtime exception, which may cause confusion and result in a degraded user experience. Cool, so that wraps up this video on using GitHub Copilot in Visual Studio. If you like this video, give it a like. If you want to see more videos on GitHub Copilot, I'm trying to get through a bunch of content before I go on leave in a couple of days. I'm actually going to Italy, where it'll be nice and warm. I'm in Melbourne at the moment. It was 2 degrees centigrade this morning, which is very, very cold. But if you want to see more videos on GitHub Copilot, please subscribe. And if you have any questions, please pop them in the comments section below. So thanks for watching, and no matter where you are in the world, I hope you're having a fantastic day, and I will see you all next time.